So the other day I read an article in the newspaper that was talking about parents ordering for their children in the midst of the pandemic. They were ordering these butterfly kits to come, and they were basically trying to bring the science classroom home to the family. And it was just something that was intended to be sort of informative for their kids and something that they could talk about. So the idea was, there was this company in California, and the company said they were selling upwards of 50,000 a day of these butterfly kits. And so if you were one of the parents that ordered one of these kits, what you got was this little jar, and inside that jar there were about three or four comatose caterpillars. And they were caterpillars that were on the way to becoming a butterfly. And so the parents bought this kit with the intention of explaining to their children the process in which a caterpillar becomes a butterfly. But what happened, and the reason why there was an article that was written on this, was to the shock and to the amazement of the parents and the 2 and 3-year-old children that were the recipients of this, is that they not only learned that caterpillars can turn into butterflies, but they also were shocked to learn, to find out that these caterpillars, whoever emerged from their coma first, would often end up cannibalizing one another. And so these parents, they were sitting down with these 2 and 3-year-old kids, would wake up in the morning and they would find the 3 caterpillars that they had originally that were going to turn into butterflies. They would find out that the caterpillars that woke up first would then go over to the sleeping caterpillar, who is cozied up and in its little tomb, and they would find themselves getting eaten, and they would have a half-eaten caterpillar the next morning. And so these parents were having to explain to the children that they didn't know this either, but that caterpillars will cannibalize each other sometimes on purpose. Now, it's one thing to find out that caterpillars apparently are cruel pieces of nature, that they do not care about the feelings and the facts or if this is logical, that they will just eat you while you are sleeping. It sounds like a horror story. It's one thing to find out sort of a random fact on that, but you know, in Scripture, we're called to be pursuers, to be inquisitive, to find out things about the Lord. In the book of Proverbs, the writer of Proverbs, he personifies wisdom as something that we're seeking to find, something that we're pursuing. And there's this passage in Proverbs chapter 8, where when the writer is talking about wisdom, he says this: "Whoever finds me is going to find life and is going to obtain favor from the Lord." My challenge to you today is really simple. It's not to find out whether or not caterpillars will cannibalize one another, but rather to push us in a direction where we are pursuing to find wisdom. Because when we pursue wisdom, the promise of Scripture is that as we find it and He finds us, we will then have favor with the Lord. God bless you.